Now the question remains, who is their father? This concept will be cleared. The mystery will be solved, confusion will be cleared, and the doubts will be removed by the help of Shiv Puran. Now let us read the holy scripture, which these fake Hindu gurus could neither read well nor understand. They only had the working knowledge of Sanskrit and no clue about the subtle knowledge, and we just blindly believed that the Sanskrit knowing people are sages, great rishis, Brahmins, who might have read the books correctly. They must have taught correctly, and God, Kabir Dev Ji, Sahib Ji, who descended in the form of a weaver 600 years ago in Banaras, he gave the realization that they all have been lying, they are not clearly acquainted with the holy texts. They have no clear knowledge of the Almighty, but that time we could not trust him, as these fraudulent gurus and teachers told us that Kabir is illiterate, who does not know Sanskrit language and lies about Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. He talks of their birth and death of and talks about their parents. God Kabir ji lies. Oi hoi. God Kabir ji told his dear soul Dharamdas ji that Dharamdas, when 5,505 years of Kali Yuga are over, it will be realized what I am telling you now is true. What? Ab main tumse kahun chitai, tir devan ki utpatti bhai. Ma ashtangi pita niranjan, ye jam darun vanshan anjan. Teen putra ashtangi jaye, Brahma Vishnu Shiv naam dharaye. What I am telling you today, that Brahma, Vishnu Mahesh's mother is Durga ji and their father is Jyot Niranjan, who is also known as Kalk Sharpurush. What I am saying today, when 5,505 years of Kali Yuga are over, then all of it will be true. At present, it is that time of Kali Yuga right now, which is 5,500 years, had completed in the year 2000 AD. Let me show you a proof now. Let me make the concept that at present it is 5,500 years. 5,500 years of Kali Yuga that is going on now. 5,511 is right now. So you can say that 5 years ago in 2000, it was 5,505 years were completed. Let me prove it to you. Look here. This is Himalaya Teerth. The name of the book is Himalaya Teerth, and it is published by the followers of Shankaracharya's tradition. Himalaya Teerth, J.P. Namburi, Deputy Chief Task Officer, Shri Badrinath Kedarnath Mandir Samiti, Treks and Tours, Kolkata, from here. The first publication came out in 2009. Publisher is Ranju Chakravarti, like this. Printer is Giri Print Service, Kolkata. Now let us show you the page number 42. Page number 42, book is Himalaya Teerth. And look, here is the description of Shankaracharya. Near Adi Kedareshwar is a divine marble statue of Shankaracharya ji. As per Shiva's secret, as per Shiv Rahasya, there is a book named Shiv Rahasya. Here is the Sanskrit from it. Trisahasra Varshanam Shankaro Yatihi, which means as 3,000 years of Kali Yuga will be over, in order to win the Buddhists, Shankar will appear in the form of an ascetic, which means that Lord Shankar himself will come in the form of Adi Shankaracharya once 3,000 years of Kali Yuga are over. in order to win over the Buddhists, Bodh Mimamsak after visual of Shankaracharya, it is written further, now another one will be shown to you. This proves that once 3,000 years of Kali Yuga are over, at that time Adi Shankaracharya will be born. This is being clearly proven by this second book that 508 before common era, that is 508 years before the era of Christ, was the Shankaracharyaji born. Have a look. This is a book, Jyotirmay Jyotirmat. He is the Adi Shankaracharyaji. And he is the one who is the present Sri Swarupanandji Shankaracharya. He is the Shankaracharya of two peats. It is more like he is the in charge of them too. This is a book, Jyotirmay Jyotirmat. And look here. This was published in January 2007. Guardian is Anant Sri Vibhushit, Jyotish Peethadhishwar and Dwarka Sharda Peethadhishwar. He is the owner of the two. Jagat Guru Shankaracharya, Swami Sri Swarupanand Saraswati Ji Maharaj. Editor, writer and compiler is Vishnu Dutt Sharma, Director of Adhyatmik Uthan Mandal, Delhi. The source of inspiration is the printer, its fine print and packs. For consultation and cooperation, publisher here is Akhil Bhartiya Adhyatmik Gyan Uthan Mandal, 1/3234 Street Number 2, Ramnagar Extension, Mandoli Road, Shahdra, Delhi. Like this. Let me show you page number 11, the life description of Adi Shankaracharya in brief. Around 2500 years ago, Shankaracharya was born during the era of unstable belief in Kerala by the bank of River Purna in Kaladi village to a religious Nambudari Shaiv Brahman, Sri Shiv Guru, and his religious wife Subhadra. Sri Shiv Guru was a Yajurvedi of the Taittiriya cult and the father of Adi Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya was born due to the blessing of Lord Shankar. Thus, he was named Shankar as per the traditional Guru Mats, Guru Paramparagat Mats. The year of his holy birth was 508 BC. Or 476 BC. It is 476 means that he died at the age of 32. Then reducing 32 from here leaves 476, which means 508 years ago from here. And as a lump sum, approx 2500 years ago, he was born about 2500 years ago, where Kaladi. It proves that 508 before Christ, 508 before Christ, they are writing in 2007, considering the 2000 years AD from then, the 508 years ago, that means from 2000, 2508 years ago, if you add it to 3000, makes 5508. This humble servant in 1994 was given the order of initiating. In year 2000, God showed mercy and blessed me that I saw these holy books. Following year, in 2000, after viewing these books, our holy religious books, this servant had created a book of his own, The Definition of God. Then there was the summarized message of God and Gehri Nazar Gita Me, where I made a literal translation of Gita Ji. So God said when 5,505 years of Kali Yuga will be over, then everything I am saying today will come to be true, Dharamdas. What did God say that Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh are mortals? They are born and they die. Brahma, Vishnu and Shivji's father, Jyoti Naranjan, Kshar Purush, he is Kal and their mother is goddess Durga, but no one believed this 600 years ago from year 1398 to 1518. God kept on repeating the same preaching for 120 years. But these fraudulent gurus and these stubborn teachers did not let this preaching of God Himself reach us. God Kabir Das Ji used to say, Ye Dunya Ajab Diwani, Meri Kahi Ek Na Mani. Look how people are becoming followers of these false teachers, that they are believing the folklore to be true. And the truth we are telling, they are not able to trust. For this, God has selected this specific time in Kali Yuga when all of the public would be properly educated. When the public is literate, the believers are literate, they can themselves read the religious books and their hearts will fill with joy. What we want is God. And all these religious texts, the holy four Vedas, the holy 18 Purans, the holy Srimad Bhagavad Gita Ji, we kept on considering true, and we still do. Then whatever is written in them, we should accept it now, we should escape the clutches of these teachers reciting folklores that will be beneficial for us. And God Kabir Ji says, Jaan Bujh Sachi Taje Aur Kare Jhoot Te Ne Taki Sangati He Prabhu Swapan Me Bhi Na De. If even after looking at all these evidences, one does not leave the false ones and accept the truth, then for them God says, Jaan Bujh Sachi Taje Aur Kare Jhoot Te Ne Taki Sangati Prabhu Swapan Me Bhi Na De. When it comes to such idiots, it's better to stay away. Those who still don't believe after looking at evidence. Even these Adi Shankaracharyas, have no proper knowledge of Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. They call them immortals. So pious souls, God Kabir Ji said, Ek na bhula, do na bhuli, ye bhuli sab sansari. Now we go further from Brahma Ji, Vishnu Ji to Shiv Ji to clarify identity of their father. And that from his life story, let's show you Shiv Puran now. Take a look at this Shiv Puran. Shiv Puran in brief, illustrated, bold font, Hindi only. Published by Gita Press Gorakhpur, Shiv Puran. In brief, illustrated, bold font, Hindi only. Editor Hanuman Prasad Poddar. Editor and printer Gita Press Gorakhpur. Govind Bhavan Karyalay, Kolkata Ka Sansthan. Now we will start from here. We start from Rudra Sanhita, page 98, Shiv Puran, in brief. The fifth chapter of Rudra Sanhita ends here. Listening to his son Narad, the father of the world, Brahmaji said the following. Now we will read the sixth chapter of Rudra Sanhita. Brahmaji said, Brahman, superior amongst the deities, you are always busy with the tasks for welfare of the world, for the very benefits of the people. You have asked this great question. When the whole world had been destroyed everywhere, there was only darkness. Neither the sun could be seen nor the moon. Nothing was known about the other planets and stars. It was neither a day nor the night. Fire, earth, water, or air, none of them existed anywhere. At that time, Tat Sat Brahm, who is heard as Sat, only he existed. Now, on page 100, Shiv Puran in brief, we are reading Rudra Sanhita about that Parabrahma, the various wise and unwise utterances, the following options are presented. He, after some time, presented the desire for a second. Within him arose the pledge to procreate, to become more from one than from that formless God. With his imagination created a shape and figure for himself. The formless God without a figure is God Sadashiv. Both ancient and modern scholars call him God. At that time, the one living alone and indulging in leisure at his own will, that Sadashiv, from his own body, he himself created a self-featured figure, Shakti, who was indispensable from his own body. That superpower is Pradhan, leader, Prakriti, nature. Now try to remember who this is. This is Durga, who was created from the body of devil. At that time, the one living alone and indulging in leisure at his own will, at Sadashiv, who is that Sadashiv? He is devil. From his own body, he himself created a self-featured femme figure, Shakti, who is indispensable from his own body. Brahmaji is telling all this. Kabirji says that Kaal had consumed Durgaji and Kabirji brought her out of there. These things are sort of similar. God Kabirji endowed this knowledge on Brahmaji. Then Brahmaji, taking some from that knowledge and some from his own experience, gave the explanation. At that time, the one living alone and indulging in leisure at his own will, that Sadashiv, who is the Sadashiv? He is devil. From his own body, he himself created a self-featured femme figure Shakti, who was indispensable from his own body. That superpower is said to be Pradhan, Prakriti, nature, Gunvati, Maya, Buddhi, Tattvaki, Janani, and Vikar Rahit. That Shakti power has been named Ambika. She is also called Prakriti, nature. Do remember that Durga is also known as Prakriti, goddess of all, and Tridev Janani, the mother of three deities, Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh. Sri Durga ji is called as Tridev Janani. She is also called Nitya and Moolkaran, created by Sadashiv. That Shakti goddess had eight arms. Did you understand? This is about Durga. Various ornaments adorn her divine figure. That goddess is thriving with various forms, qualities, talents, conditions, and she possesses a number of armaments. Clear? Although she is solitary, coincidentally, Maya takes the form of more than one. She was the one who made three forms, Savitri, Lakshmi, and Uma, who married Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiv. Although she is solitary, coincidentally, Maya takes the form of more than one. She was the one who made three forms. He who is Sadashiv. This is the information on Kshar Purush, Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh's father. He is called Param Purush, Ishwar, Lord, Shiv, Shambhu, and Maheshwar. Now see, page 101. Oho, Rudra Sahita. Chapter 6th is what we are reading. They completely smear themselves with ash. That devil faced Brahm. You can call him Kaal or call him Brahm. Call him Kshar-Purush or Jyoti Niranjan. That Kaal faced Brahm along with Shakti. It is a misprint. Along with Shakti, that is Durga, had created a Shivlok at the same time. That great place is known as Kashi. That is the place for Param Nirvan or Moksh, which is located right at the top of it all. They in the form of lover and beloved, Shakti and Shiv, Aha. In form of lover and beloved, which means as a husband and wife, Durga with devil. Either call him Kaal, Kaal face Brahm, or call him Sadashiv, the father of Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. Durga and devil in their eternal ecstatic form reside in that beautiful place, Shiv and Shiva. Here he is the Kaal faced Brahm, because sometimes he disguises as a son Shiv too, because he never comes face to face with anyone in his true form. Shiv, who is Kaal, the Kaal faced Brahm, he and his wife, Shiv and Shiva, who are Kaal and Durga, did not abandon that place even at the time of apocalypse or the ultimate doom. Devarshi, Brahmaji is telling Naraji, at one time, while wandering in tranquility in the paradise, Shiva and Shiv, Kaal and Durga, Durga and Kaal, had a desire of creating another male, that is, to procreate in form of a son, on whom the burden of regulation of the universe can be laid so that we both could live in Kashi and have our own will leisure and enjoy Nirvana. Once the decision was made, the Almighty, Universal Lord Shiv, Kal-faced Brahma, shared an intimate relation with Durga, rubbed nectar on the 10th part of his left side, consummated as a couple, then there appeared a male entity, a son was born. Look at page 102 of Shiv Puran in brief that we are reading. Right then, to the son who was born, the devil-faced Brahma, the devil-faced Brahma means this Shiv said, "Child, since you are vast and comprehensive, your name should be popular as Vishnu." So the child that was born of Durga and Kal, he was named Vishnu. Chapter 6 of Rudra Sanhita has been read. Pious souls, these are the same religious books which we considered as the base for acquisition of our knowledge. The teachers, Brahmins, Gurus, they used to tell us so. And so is written in Shiv Puran. That is the reason we are telling you, such is written in Vishnu Puran or in Devi Puran, and we used to trust what they used to say, the folk tales told by them, because we thought that they have the knowledge of Sanskrit language. Today, all these holy books are saying just opposite to the folk tales. That makes it clear that devil-faced Brahm, Kshar-purush, Jyoti Niranjan, Kal or Sada, Shiv, call him what you may, he's the father of Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh, and call her Durga, Prakriti, she is their mother. It is the union of them both that created Sri Vishnu. This is being clarified by Shiv Puran, the chapter 6th of Rudra Sanhita. Then in the 7th chapter, Brahmaji says, "Then even I originated, the same way by the union of Durga and Kal, they together created." Take a look, this is Rudra Sanhita. And we have read chapter 6th up till here. Now we look at the 7th. On the page 103, Brahmaji says, "Devarshi, sage of the deities." Brahmaji addresses Naradji as sage of the deities. After that, the merciful and all-gracious Sadashiv, just like the way he created Vishnu, created me too, from his right side, and immediately enchanting me with his powers, placed me in the Nabhi lotus of Narayan, and then used his power to make me appear from there. This is how, as the son of the lotus, I, Hiranyagarbha, was born. Now here, Pious Souls, the translator, got a bit anxious and confused. He thought, how do I write about the creation of Shiv out of Shiv? Because the translator was oblivious to the true spiritual knowledge, and that is why it is said that truth cannot be hidden. Chor churave tumbdi aur gaade pani mein, wo gaade wo par aave, no sachai chhani ne. Now take a look. This is the Rudra Sanhita that we are reading. We will show you the proof in Sri Shiv Puran. This is the same Rudra Sanhita. And concise Shiv Puran on page 110. Now we look here. Here, 9th chapter ends. This is the last part. In this way, Brahma, Vishnu, and Rudra are the three deities with qualities. In this way, Brahma, Vishnu, and Rudra are three deities with respective qualities, but Shiv is considered to be out of the ambit of such qualities. Have a look at it. These are Brahma, Vishnu, and Rudra, and they are different from the Kal-faced Brahma. That makes a total of 4. We will clarify it more.